Welcome to day 15 of journaling. For those of you who may be joining us, this may be your first time. We are taking a 30-day challenge to learn how to journal about our own lives. This is for our own personal history and our own personal thoughts. Now, you can download the journal from our website, freshlivingstreet.com. You can go to the resource page and you can download a PDF. You can print it out yourself. And this just works as a primer journal. This is just to help you getting you started. Now you may say, well, this is day 15. You can go to YouTube and you can start with day one. And this is a living journal. So it doesn't have to be today that you start. You can just go back and find day one and you can start with day one. And for those of you who have been sticking with us, thank you. And we really appreciate it because this is for you. Now, our first blast from the past is, if I chose a certain age to be forever, that means to live at this age forever, what age would that be? Now, I think a lot of us can go back and we kind of like through the years. Like for me, if I could be 17 again, just for the rest of my life, I would be a happy camper. It was a time of exploration. It was a time of almost being grown but not grown, and it was a time of just so many. That year was filled with so many new adventures and so many different type of people. It was just a thrill for me every day getting up. So if you could go back in your life, think about how old would you be if you could, if it was an age that you could be forever, what age would that be, and write why it would be that age for you. Our next one is my present. It says, am I happy where I am right now? It's asking about your job, your love life, friendship, living situations, etc. This is a very important question, because if you're not telling yourself the truth, then you continue a pattern. But if you can look and say, no, I'm not really happy with this job, it's just meeting the bills, but this is not what I really want to do, then write down what the job it is that you want. Or if you're in a relationship and it's not exactly what you thought it would be, and just to be honest, you're not happy. And why are you staying? And what is your motivation? What is your hope and aspiration for that relationship? Today is the only day that you've been promised that by the universe that you can have. Tomorrow is just a dream. The past is over. But today you can begin asking those questions. Am I really happy? And if I am happy, why I am happy? And if I'm not happy, why am I not happy? So you can begin to really deal with those things inside of you as to what it is that you want. Because the choices we make today are the things that will affect our future, and it will become our future. Our last one is my future. It says, what will be my life's work or passion? It's very important that each one of us realize we've been put on this earth for a reason, and it's to uplift humanity. And all of us have a passion, whether it's music, writing, cooking, cleaning, whatever your passion is. And it's important every day to wake up doing something that makes you feel alive, something that you want to do. It's not like you're just dragging yourself out. You know, you wake up and you say, damn, I gotta get up. No, it's a thing where you want to get up because your passion is waiting for you, and your passion makes you feel fulfilled, and also it helps others. And it's important for your future that if you're not doing your passion today, that you begin to discover what it is. Now, list your passion or your work and what it is. Because remember, what we think on expands. What we think about, we bring about. And your future can only be what you think about. And so, in the last one, what will be my life's work, or what is my passion? So that you can get to doing, or get started doing your passion. Thank you for joining today. And remember, we're here to learn and to understand. Be well. See you tomorrow.